summation of the life of St. Lawrence Ruiz and his companions. Lorenzo was born in Manila of a Chinese father and a Filipino mother, both Christians. He learned Chinese and Tagalog from them and Spanish from the Dominicans whom he served as an altar boy and sacristan. He became a professional calligrapher, transcribing documents in beautiful penmanship. He was a full member of the Confraternity of the Holy Rosary under the Dominicans. He married and had two sons and a daughter. His life took an abrupt turn when he was accused of murder. Nothing further is known except the statement of two Dominicans that he was sought by the authorities on account of a homicide to which he was present or which was attributed to him. At the time, three Dominican priests were about to sail to Japan in spite of a violent persecution there. With them was a Japanese priest and a layman named Lazaro, who was a leper. Lorenzo, having taken asylum with them, was allowed to accompany them, but only while they were at sea did he learn that they were going to Japan. They landed at Okinawa. Lorenzo could have gone on to Taiwan, but, he says, I decided to stay with the fathers because the Spaniards would hang me there. In Japan, they were soon found out, arrested, and taken to Nagasaki. That was the site of wholesale bloodshed and the place where the first atomic bomb was dropped. The 50,000 Catholics who once lived there were dispersed or killed by persecution. The men were subjected to an unspeakable kind of torture. After huge quantities of water were forced down their throats, they were made to lie down. Long boards were placed on their stomachs, and guards then stepped on the boards, forcing the water to spurt violently from mouth, nose, and ears. The superior, Antonio, died after some days. Both the Japanese priest and Lazaro broke under torture, which included the insertion of bamboo needles under their fingernails. Both were brought back to courage, however, by their companions. In Lorenzo's moment of crisis, he asked the interpreter, "I would like to know that if I deny my faith, they will spare my life." The interpreter was noncommittal, but Lorenzo, in the final hours, felt his faith grow strong. He became bold, even audacious, with his interrogators. The five were eventually put to death by being hanged upside down over a pit. Boards fitted with semicircular holes were fitted around their waists and stones put on top to increase the pressure. They were tightly bound to slow circulation and prevent a speedy death. They were allowed to hang for 3 days. By that time, Lorenzo and Lazaro were dead. The three Dominican priests still alive were beheaded. John Paul II canonized these six and 10 others, Asians and Europeans, men and women, who spread the faith in the Philippines, Taiwan, and Japan. Lorenzo Ruiz is the first canonized Filipino martyr. We ordinary Christians of today, how would we stand up in the circumstances that these martyrs face? We sympathize with the two who temporarily denied the faith. We understand Lorenzo's terrible moment, temptation, but we also see the courage, unexplainable in human terms, which surged from their store of faith. Martyrdom, like ordinary life,